En de Anton de Kom Universiteit heeft een internationale conferentie georganiseerd getiteld Legacy of Slavery and Indentured Labor, Linking the Past with the Future. Het doel van de conferentie was onder meer om de resultaten van wetenschappelijk onderzoek over bovengenoemde onderwerpen uit te wisselen. Vanmorgen zijn er panelsessies gehouden met internationale sprekers. De Trinidadiaan Amba Pandey hield een presentatie over diaspora en ontwikkeling.
Very important area where in future India's interests can converge with old diaspora is with regard to India's growing interest in blue economy. Most of the countries where the old or the Girmay diaspora is settled are future hubs of blue economy, and there lies a huge potential for India to tap. So, if India can harmonize its foreign policy priorities with the interests and concerns of the old diaspora, it will be able to convert a huge asset out of it. It's a tightrope walk, no doubt, but there are ways to go about it. Instead of direct intervention, India can increase its presence through private sector in terms of opening offshore campuses, etc. India can also engage with the youth of the Girmay diaspora by increasing the number of scholarships for them and giving them opportunities to visit India. So I will skip other parts and I will end by saying that by converging its interests with that of Girmay diaspora, India can create an asset in a win-win game for both.
Alus een van de internationale sprekers, Amba Pandey. De presentatie van David Pradhan ging over bloed, zweet en tranen, reparaties voor historische contributie van contractarbeid.
Another thing that we should also understand that claiming money from the successor governments could be demeaning to the suffering that the indentured laborers had suffered. So placing a pecuniary price on what they had undergone would be unethical, according to some scholars. And so therefore, maybe it should be also looked into in various cases where the money was paid, like in South Africa, it was a pittance which was blown off in a few days' time. So what we can expect from this entire process is that there will be an acknowledgement and an apology as a first step, an acknowledgement that something wrong was done, which is still not the case. There are people still, as in Bristol, someone was pointing out the other day, that the descendants of the slaves are paying the slave masters for the reparations that the slave masters were paid in England. So, but at this point of time, in the existing jurisprudential legal system, I would say there is very, very little chances, and it is a far-fetched idea that.
David Pradhan, een van de buitenlandse sprekers tijdens de panelsessie van de internationale conferentie over slavernij en contractarbeid. De conferentie is georganiseerd ter gelegenheid van de Lusrumhut, de herdenkingen en het 50-jarig bestaan van de Universiteit van Suriname.